On August 11th, 1907, the Cardinals' Ed Carger throws a perfect game against the Boston Doves in the second game of a doubleheader. The game was shortened to 7 innings by prior agreement, which was commonplace at the time. This is the only abridged perfect game or no-hitter that was not shortened by weather in the history of the game. After missing 6 weeks, first with broken ribs, then a thumb broken in a fight with a butcher's clerk, Ty Cobb signs a new 3-year contract and returns to the Tigers lineup on August 11, 1914. Cobb would play in only 97 games that season, but would still go on to win another batting crown, hitting .368. Under existing rules, his .345 at-bats were enough to qualify. Where have you gone, Joe DiMaggio? August 11th, 1950, hitting just .279 and languishing in a 4-for-38 slump, Yankee great Joe DiMaggio is benched for the first time in his career. His replacement, Cliff Mapes, gives the Yankees a 7-6 win over the A's with a mammoth 7th-inning homer. 1979, Phillies reliever Tug McGraw surrenders an 8th-inning grand slam to the Pirates' Ed Ott as the Bucks win 14-11. This would be the 4th grand slam McGraw gave up that season, setting a new National League mark and tying with Detroit's Ray Nolesky, who did it in 1959. The Cubs paraded out 10 pitchers in a 17-inning 10-8 loss to the Pirates on August 11, 1985. This game is the continuation of a contest that started on April 20th but was suspended because of darkness. Barry Jones, the winning pitcher who struck out the side, and Barry Bonds, who drove in the game-winning run, were both in the minors when the game started. The losing Frank Dipino started the season with Houston. August 11th, 2009, Boston's 7-5 win over Detroit at Fenway Park is marred by a brawl in the second inning. When Kevin Youkilis is hit by a Rick Porcello pitch, he charges the mound and both benches empty. Both players are ejected and Youk's replacement, Mike Lowell, hits 2 home runs to power the Red Sox to victory. That was August 11th, this day in baseball.